They were all exceptionally inspiring projects, and I know the judging panel had a difficult task choosing one winner from them. The entries bear testimony to the commitment of NUT members to equality campaigns and the breadth of the work going on day in, day out by union members. I'm delighted to announce that this year the award is to be given to Daniel Pavidi from North Tyneside. Woo!
Woo! Go, Dan!
Organised and delivered workshops on anti-racism within his school and teaches philosophy to children about the refugee crisis, working collaboratively with Show Racism the Red Card. He is working with the Islamic Diversity Centre in Newcastle to organise a football tournament for Challenge Islamophobia Day. He organised the first charity music festival in Newcastle in 2015. In the atmosphere of racism and Islamophobia prevalent today, Daniel's work within school and the wider local and regional community continues to be an exemplary contribution to ensuring the NUT's message that cultural diversity is our greatest asset and strength is spread. And I think Kevin is going to award Daniel, and then he's going to say thank you.
Teacher and anti-racism campaigner, it fills me with an immense sense of pride to be receiving this award in Blair's name. Now, as you heard, there's a number of organisations that I represent. Please take some time to perhaps read about their journey on the board outside. A lot has been focused about teaching children about racism, but also building a movement against racism and fascism in our community. Now, there's no way I can accept this award as an individual. I've had the privilege of working with some of the nation's most deprived and challenging young people whose anti-racist and inquiring minds never cease to amaze me. I've had the privilege of working with some great organisations, Stand Up to Racism, Show Racism the Red Card, Islamic Diversity Centre. I've had the privilege of working with some amazing people in building the Anti-Racist Coalition Newcastle Unites and in building the Unity Festival. And I'd like to pay tribute to the people, some of them in this room who've been a part of building that movement. So to the NUT activist Tony Dowling and the many activists in the Northern region, the award is for you also. But more than that, I'd like to accept this award on behalf of every anti-racist teacher, every anti-racist teaching assistant, and every anti-racist head who puts combating this great evil of racism at the heart of education. I'd also like to pay tribute to our General Secretary, Kevin Courtney, who's not only supported the anti-racist activities that I've initiated, but has continued our union's great tradition of putting equality first. Because that is what we should all be doing, putting equality first. The fight against racism and discrimination is not an appendage, it is not peripheral, and it is not too political. Equality must continue to be at the front and centre of everything we do for our students and as a trade union. There's a toxic and racist narrative being put forward by our government that seems to blame the powerless and not the powerful for the society's ills, and their racist lives must be resisted. We must resist a government that wants us to demonise Muslims and treat them as suspects. We must resist a government that wants us to act as their immigration control. And we must resist a government that seeks to blame migrants and refugees for the pressures on schools instead of their failing cuts of their failing policy, sorry, of cuts and privatisation. Conference. When everything we do is underpinned by the fight for justice and equality, we win for every school, for every teacher, and every student. The world has changed since we last met. We are exiting the EU, and we now live in a world of Trump. But let 2017 not be a year of fear and pessimism, but be a year of hope and coming together. Because as Blair Peach played his role in defeating the National Front, and I've played mine in defeating the BNP and EDL, we can all play our role in defeating the racism of Theresa May, Marine Le Pen, and Donald Trump. So conference, be the Sathya Khans of this world, and turn out on the streets and oppose the racists when they're in your community. Be the Sarah Tomlinsons of this world and build a movement that welcomes migrants and refugees. And all of us be there when Trump visits and send out a clear message that the politics of racism, sexism and bigotry are not welcome in our schools and are not welcome in our communities. As our union goes through its transitions and changes, may it continue to be a beacon of light in a world of growing uncertainty. May each and every one of us go back to our schools and go back to our communities and build a world where black lives matter, where anti-migrant racism, Islamophobia, anti-Semitism and all other forms of racism no longer exist, but are things taught about in history books. Friends, I accept this award. Thank you.